From ages, the kingdom of Bhutan or the land of thunder dragons is famous for its breathtaking landscapes. Other than its most popular scenic beauty, the socio-economic history of Bhutan needs a special mention. This Buddhist country has never been colonized. In 2008, Bhutan transitioned from an absolute monarchy to a constitutional monarchy. The first general election to the National Assembly of Bhutan was held in that year. Bhutan is renowned as one of the most peaceful countries of South Asia. The financial center of this country is Phuntsholing. You can reach Bhutan by train, air or road from India. By train, first reach Hashimara or New Alipurduar or New Jalpaiguri station. From each station, you will get taxi or bus service to reach Indian town Jaigaon. If you are traveling by road, then also reach Jaigaon first. The distance of Jaigaon from Hashimara is 17 km and it is 44 minutes drive. From New Alipurduar, the distance is 60 km and it will take 1 hour to reach Jaigaon by car from New Alipurduar. From New Jalpaiguri, Jaigaon is 148 km away and it is a 3.5 hour drive. At Jaigaon, complete all formalities at the immigration office and get the permit to enter Bhutan. You can take Indian card to Bhutan, but it will require separate permit. Indians don't need a visa to enter Bhutan. You will have to produce 2 copies of passport size photograph and your photo identity proof at the immigration office to get your permit free of cost. Remember, this permit is only for traveling Thimphu and Paro. You will have to take separate permit from Thimphu immigration office to visit other places of Bhutan. After getting the permit, cross the border of 2 countries and reach Phuntsholing of Bhutan. By air, directly reach Paro International Airport. From India, you can avail the flights of Druk Air, Royal Bhutan Airlines to reach Bhutan. After reaching Paro, complete all formalities at Paro Immigration Office and get your required permit. On day 2, go to Thimphu from Phuntsholing or Paro. The distance of Thimphu from Phuntsholing is 164.6 km. It will take 4 hours and 40 minutes to reach Thimphu from Phuntsholing. On your way, visit the confluence of 2 Bhutanese rivers, Thimphu Chu and Paro Chu. The distance of Thimphu from Paro is 50.8 km and it will take 1 hour 20 minutes to reach Thimphu from Paro via Thimphu Highway. Day 3. On day 3, go for local sightseeing in Thimphu. The must visit tourist attractions are Clock Tower Square. Clock Tower Square is a famous landmark in the capital city of Bhutan, Thimphu. The tower has 4 clocks, one on each side, and has some beautiful artistic carving and paintings. The tower is located below Norzim Lam in the center of Thimphu. Don't miss the cuisine served at food joints nearby. Tango Buddhist Institute. The Tango Buddhist Institute was founded by Lama Gyalwar Lhampa in 13th century. The place is famous for its beautiful monastery set in the background of stunning natural beauty. The institute is located 14 kilometers from Thimphu. Changkha Lakhang. Hanging on top of a ridge above Thimphu, Changkha Lakhang is the oldest temple in Thimphu. The temple was built in 12th century and houses the central statue of Chenrezi, a manifestation of Avalokiteshvar with 11 heads and 1000 arms. It is just 10 minutes drive from the main market of Thimphu. National Library. National Library of Bhutan or NLB was established in 1967 and possesses a wide collection of 6,100 Bhutanese and Tibetan books, xylographs and manuscripts, 9,000 printing boards and wooden printing blocks for religious books. Dochula Pass. Dochula Pass is a scenic spot located more than 10,000 feet above sea level. It is one of the most renowned destinations for tourists in Bhutan. The pass is located at a height of 10,171 feet on east-west road from Thimphu to Punakha. Buddha Dodirma, one of the largest Buddha statues in the world, Buddha Dodirma is a masterpiece of architectural wonder. The massive bronze statue is over 50 meters in height and is covered with gold. Apart from this, it also houses 125,000 other Buddha statues that are placed surrounding the Buddha Dodirma statue. Tashichu Zong is a remarkable architectural structure which currently is the house of the throne room and seat of the government. The Zong was built in 1641 by Zhabdrung on the grounds of Do Nong Zong, which was earlier built by Lama Gyalwa Lahangpa. Motithang Takin Preserve is a wildlife reserve region to protect the national animal of Bhutan, Takin. Apart from Takins, you can also find sambars and deers. It is 15 minutes drive away from Thimphu bus station. On 4th day, early in the morning, go to Punakha from Thimphu. Punakha is 86 km away from Thimphu and it takes 2 hours 30 minutes to reach Punakha from Thimphu by car. The local cafe for the trip is around Rs. 900. On your way to Punakha, visit Gangtek Goemba in Phobjika Valley. Upon reaching Punakha, go for local sightseeing. Places of interest are Chimi Lakhang Temple. Chimi Lakhang is one of the most sacred temples of Bhutan and is considered as the temple of fertility dedicated to Lama Drukpa Kuenle, popularly known as Divine Madman. Khamsum Yolwe Namgyal Chorten is an example of beautiful traditional architecture of Bhutan. The temple was built by Her Majesty the Queen Mother to bring peace and harmony to all living beings. Punakha Zong. Punakha Zong is a beautiful architecture and offers a stunning view of the glowing whitewashed wall on a bright sunny day. Golden, red and black painted woods add to the charisma of this striking architecture. Day 5. On day 5, go to Paro from Punakha. The distance is 127 km and it will take 3.5 hours to reach Paro from Punakha. Local car rate is around Rs. 1000. Upon arriving Paro, go to visit Chelela Pass. It is a 2 hours drive from Paro. Situated at an altitude of 3988 meters above the sea level, it is the highest point of Bhutan Highway. You will get a beautiful view of Mount Jomolhari, the second highest peak of Bhutan, from Chelela Pass. Day 6. On day 6, go to Taksang Monastery. On your way to Taksang Monastery, first visit Paro Chu River. It is a river of western Bhutan and is a branch of the Wong Chu. Taksang Monastery is 10 km away from Paro town. Located at a height of 1200 meters on top of a hill, it is a 2 hours trek. The trek is famous for its stunning natural beauty. Enjoy the fresh greeneries on your way up and down. The temple was built in 1692 near the Taksang Senge Samduk cave. As per the legend, Padmasambhava or Guru Rinpoche flew to this place from Tibet on the back of a tigress. That is the reason this place is also known as Tiger's Nest. On 7th day, return back to Paro International Airport or Funchalin for departure.